Welcome back to Sports Line, everybody. John Burton with you until the top of the hour. Glad you are with us. Coming up later in the hour, we'll update you on the Preds game there in Toronto tonight, looking for a win over the Maple Leafs. And Vanderbilt, the men's basketball team there, playing host to Georgia tonight at Memorial Gym. We'll have updates on those games for you as we go on throughout the hour. Meantime, as we said, it is National Signing Day across the college football landscape, and today marked the first recruiting class for new Tennessee head coach Jeremy Pruitt. And here's what he had to say after everything was signed, sealed, and delivered.
No, first off, I'd just like to say that, you know, we're excited about the 20 young men that we've added to this class. You know, these guys are going to lay the foundation for the next 4 to 5 years and what we're trying to build. And these are the guys that wanted to be a part of what we're trying to get done. And we're excited to have them. I'm just going to kind of go through the list and talk about them a little bit. The first guy is Trayvon Flowers, a young man out of Tucker High School in Atlanta, Georgia. A very unique situation where he was a baseball player, hadn't played football since his eighth grade year, came out his senior year. I saw him practice one time this past fall. Very unique individual, has a very good skill set at defensive back. He could probably play all six positions back there. I think this guy's going to be a really good player for us one day. Karat Garland, a young man that we found kind of over the break during bowl prep. We kind of went through and was looking at all the All-State teams and just trying to find guys that possibly were under the radar. This guy is a very good football player. He's really good with his hands. He fits a need as far as a guy inside that could play defensive tackle for us. He's 260 pounds right now, and he looks like a guy that could possibly be a 290-pound guy one day. So, really good football player. Emmett Gooden. Emmett's been trying to get to Tennessee for several years now. He's at junior college right now in Independence. He will actually be a late qualifier. He's going to finish up in May. He's got a little bit of work to do, but he's a big man. He's probably 6'4", 300 pounds with really good motor. And again, it's another guy that fits us up inside what we're trying to do defensively. John Mincy. John Mincy is from Clinch County in South Georgia. He's a guy that we've been following for several years. Probably all of our guys on our staff have had him in camp at some point in time. He's probably 6'4", 260 pounds right now with a great frame, very athletic, plays basketball. Another guy that on the defensive front. J.J. Peterson from Moultrie, Georgia, Colquitt County High School, has a very unique skill at linebacker. He could actually play all four positions, inside or outside. He's a guy that can play man-to-man on third down. He could rush the quarterback, but it's a guy that makes plays in space also. Cedric Tillman, Las Vegas, Nevada, wide receiver. Just come across him a couple of days ago. We're just trying to finish out our class and start looking at some of the better programs across the country. Bishop Gorman, these high schools had a ton of success over the years. He's 6'2", 206 pounds, very good student. If you looked, I think they played They played a national schedule this past year, and the three national teams that they played, I think he had 237 yards receiving, very long arms, big catch radius, a guy that could be hard to guard. You know, in our early signing period, hadn't really had a chance to talk to you about it, but Jordan Allen, young man from San Francisco, he's a guy that we actually, in the last week, we got him on the phone on a Wednesday night. He visits on a Friday. On Monday, he calls and tells us that he's going to come to Tennessee. He's a guy that's here. It's mid-year right now, working hard. He's 6'3", he's 230 pounds, and every day he sends me a text of how much he weighs. He's trying to get to 245 in a hurry. Tanner Antonetti from Nashville, Tennessee, offensive lineman. He's 6'5", 280 pounds right now. He actually plays basketball. He's very athletic. He's played tight end in the past. He's a guy that you can see that's got a frame that will grow and continue to grow, and he's a guy that wants to be at Tennessee. Jeremy Banks from Cordova, Tennessee, 6'2", 225 pounds, running back. He's a guy that can make you miss. He can run with power, and he's got home run ability. He's got soft hands, very physical guy. And for us, I think it was a big need for us to get us a big physical back. Paxton Brooks. Paxton's from West Columbia, South Carolina. You know, you look at him when he come in, I didn't know what position he played. He's about 6'4", probably about 150 pounds. I saw him in the weight room yesterday. Looks like he's bulked up. He's probably 162 now. But punter, he actually can do all three. He can kick field goals. He can kick off. But probably his specialty is punting. And he's really talented, and we're excited to have him. Jerome Carvin's a big man from Cordova, Tennessee, 6'4", 330 pounds. I actually had seen him in camp before. Jerome can bend. He's got power. He's a smart guy. He's enrolled early, so we'll get a chance to see him this spring. Greg Emerson. Greg is from Jackson, Tennessee. He's 6'3", 305 pounds right now. You know, Greg didn't play this past year. He had an injury, but he's working out right now. He's a mid-year enrollee. He's doing an outstanding job. He's almost cleared now to where he can do everything that we need him to do. Kingston Harris. From Orlando, Florida. Kingston is 6'4". He's 298 pounds. He's not with us right now. He will be here in May. Kingston is a defensive tackle, very athletic, long arm. He's going to be a big man. Jameer Johnson. Jameer's from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, but played at Arizona Western Junior College. He's 6'5". He's 280 pounds. He actually has 3 years left to play. Guy that's got really good feet, can slide his feet, has good balance, body control. Obviously, he probably needs to put on a few pounds, but he's got the frame to do it, and he's working hard at it. Ollie Lane from right here in Knoxville. Ollie's 6'3", he's 302 pounds, offensive lineman. He played in an option offense in high school, a really good run blocker. He's mid-year, he's here, he's working hard. You can tell that he's getting stronger in the weight room. Brant Lawless, defensive tackle out of Nashville, Tennessee. Brant is 6'1". He's 300 pounds. Got really good ability as a basketball player. Got really good balance, body control, can strike. Another D lineman. JT Shrout. JT is out of California. He's 6'3", 190 pounds. A guy that was committed to another university. We found him when we were out there in California. Tyson had some ties in the school, and we're excited to have him. Alante Taylor from Manchester, Tennessee, wide receiver, 6 foot, 190 pounds. Alante's here at mid-year, and he's working really hard. Jacob Warren from here in Knoxville, 6'6", 212 pounds, is a tight end. Jacob is probably in high school, played more wide receiver, and he knows that he's got to put on some pounds to play tight end, but he's working hard to do it. Dominic Woods Anderson, 6'5", 245 pounds, out of Spring Valley, California, from Arizona Western Junior College. He's a very talented guy who could actually block in the C area. He could flex out at a wide receiver, but could be a mismatch guy. You know, all these guys, the guys that are here right now, they're working hard in their off-season conditioning. We've been doing it now for 3 weeks. Hadn't had a chance to see them yet. We're going to start our winter conditioning in probably another 10 days and getting prepared for spring training.
There you go. New Tennessee coach Jeremy Pruitt breaking down his entire 2018 recruiting class here on National Signing Day. The coach obviously anxious to get his new recruits in and blend them with the veterans that are coming back as he begins his first year as head coach on Rocky Top. We'll come back. We'll talk more about Signing Day. We'll check in close to home at Vanderbilt. See how Derek Mason feels about his recruiting class for 2018. Stay with us. We're coming right back.